survival of degraded river channel in Punjab using inflated rubber dam. This is a pilot project. This is a pilot project, and it is being implemented by PMO for Barrages, Irrigation Department, through Project Implementation Consultant, PICS. PICS is a joint venture of ACE, NESPAK, and SMEC. And the funding of this project is through World Bank, out of the saving of the IBRD loan of Jina Barrage Rehabilitation Project. After the Indus Water Treaty, major river reaches of Ravi and Sutlej, they have been degraded due to lack of water flow and much lower than the original annual flood. Since these rivers are the major source of groundwater recharge, and with the dying of river channel, groundwater is severely affected, and with the shrinking of the channel, people are moving into the riverbed. And it is very important that there must be some water in the river channel in the shape of impounding the channel so that groundwater can be recharged, as well as the people who are moving into the river channels, they can be discouraged to settle in that area. And this can easily be done with the help of rubber dam. Rubber dam is a very, now I can say, old technology. For last 50 years, there are several rubber dams in different countries. Unfortunately, in Pakistan, we have not yet adopted this technology. And today, I will share with you our finding. Since we have been doing this project for almost now 18 months, we have collected data, we have visited several rubber dam installations, we have meaningful discussion with the consultant, designer, and the owner of the projects. So I will share all with that. These are some pictures of the River Ravi and River Sutlej. You can see all along that river have been degraded. There is practically no water, or very few water, and we have to stabilize this situation with the help of rubber dam. In my presentation, I will first describe the rubber dam technology, and then I will show some of the project where I have been visiting and have discussion with them, and then later on we will discuss our pilot project on River Sutlej. This is one rubber dam in China we have visited, and if we look into this, we have found that normally the best place to place a rubber dam is downstream of a bridge, because we cannot make bridge on the rubber dam. So all sites where we have bridges, they are practically a very safe and practical sites to build a rubber dam. Rubber dam is basically a reinforced rubber bladder which is anchored to concrete foundation with anchor bolt. We can pump water or air to inflate the rubber dam, and similarly we can deflate it. Compared to conventional dam, the rubber dam have advantages. It is cheap, shorter construction period, relatively longer service life, and very simple to maintain. Another thing with our case is our rivers are very wide. On the average, if I see Ravi or Sutlej, the average width is about 700 meters, about 3,000 feet wide. And to make a barrage or a dam on 7,000 feet wide river is very expensive. And especially if we see the hydrology of these two rivers, practically there is no flow throughout the year except, say, few flow or flashes of flood end of September or early October. So with rubber dam technology, we can make rubber dam with once when there is some flow in the river, we can raise the rubber dam, contain that all flow retain in the river, and then when floods come, we can deflate it. There are locations where rubber dam can be used for cleaning water, groundwater recharges, irrigation purpose, recreation purposes. And all these things can be done in Pakistan also. Basically, there are two types of rubber dam. One is air inflated rubber dams and the other is water inflated rubber dam. Both have their advantages and disadvantages. And during our visit to China and with the other manufacturers, we have particularly discussed the benefit and disadvantages of both the type. And I will discuss in a little while what we are doing for in our case. And basically there are four components in the construction of rubber dam. The first is the concrete foundation, because rubber dam can only be mounted on a concrete foundation. Then we need rubber fabric and some clamps and anchor fitting. Then control house, where we can put pumps or mechanical equipment and piping system. During the China visit, basically it is a rubber bladder, very simple to operate, and then there is a foundation for energy dissipation and mounting of the And we basically visited two types of dam. One was irrigation dams, where they retain water and provide sluiceways, and the other was the dams where they impound the water for hydropowers. So these both type of dams I'm shown. The best thing with rubber dam is that rubber dam have a very large span up to 100 meters. So we don't need piers after every 60 feet in case of a regular gated structure. The piers are very thin, almost a meter wide. So in our case, in our wide rivers, we can have 6 or 7 or maximum 9 piers to make the rubber dam structure. We have discussed the technology with their design institute. We have been to sites with the manufacturers and saw the technology, how they are making. And based on that, we came back to Pakistan and then we carried out a feasibility study for a Sutlej River project. This is the site on Sutlej River. Basically, it is on N55 near Lodhra and the road connecting Lodhra to Bahawalpur. Here you can see the river is almost dry. Okay, there are basically three bridges, two road bridges, one for incoming and outgoing, and the other is a railway bridge. So we have selected this site and we will make the rubber dam about 300 meter downstream of the railway bridge, road bridge. For this purpose, we have done all the necessary studies for like topographic survey, geological and geotechnical investigation, layout planning, hydrological studies, groundwater investigation, environmental assessment, quality controls, and economic analysis. We have decided to make a 2.5 meter high rubber dam. And since the area is very plain, very flat, we found out that the lake lake will go up to 19 kilometer with 2.5 meter high rubber dam, and the area of the lake will be about 7,200 acre feet. Okay, this is the site. On the left is the railway bridge, and then there are two road bridge, and downstream of the road bridge, we are making the rubber dam site. We are providing two sluiceway, because we found out through survey that during flood season, lot of garbage, big tree, trunks, trees, they come with the high flood. And there were chance that they may puncture the rubber. Though rubber is normally for the tube is almost about 15 to 20 millimeter thick, but even then we provided two sluiceway just in case we want to get rid of that floating debris. This is the section. Basically, the foundation will be designed as we design the barrage foundation, with all the structure is secured with sheet piles. And instead of making a weir, we put the rubber bladder with the help of anchors. This is the hydrology of the site. We see we have very little flow, less than on the average 100 Q6 on the average, and yes, during flood flow, please, we have very high flow. So we have decided that during flow season, this summer season, we will deflate the rubber dam and get rid of all the flood water, and once the water is gone, then we will inflate the rubber dam and contain the low flow water. These are the basic parameters of the rubber dam. Basically, rubber dam will be designed to overflow 2,000 cubic feet, and each sluiceway can pass about 2,000 additional flow. Rubber dam will be water fill type, and height will be about 2.5 meter. There will be 10 bays, and each bay will be about 188, or it's about 60 meter wide. And number of pier will be 9, and it will be protected with the help of sheet piles. Okay. And the overall project cost is about 1.6 billion rupees. It also, this 1.6 billion contain the cost of the land and the resettlement cost also. So these are the 3D views of the as-built rubber dam. We have done some architectural work on the pier, so we can show you. This is basically the rubber dam. This is sluiceway. The section through sluiceway. And these are the different shapes of pier and architectural work done on the piers. Since it is located in Bahawalpur, so we try to simulate that